गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर सविता तिदमे। आई एम वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, KTHM कॉलेज, नाशिक। इन दिस सेमेस्टर आई विल बी टीचिंग विद द सब्जेक्ट एनिमल इकोलॉजी, दैट इज जूलॉजी पेपर 2, एंड द कोर्स कोड इज ZO112। So in the present lecture, we'll be studying the chapter 1, that is Introduction to Ecology. Now let's move ahead and start with the topic, that is concept of ecology. Ecology is one of the important branches of science, which is also called as environmental biology. This is one of the young branch of science which is connected with the organism and their environment. Okay, see here I have shown the picture of a shark and its environment, that is ocean environment, ocean ecosystem. So here in this case, this shark and this ecosystem, they are interconnected with one another. So this name ecology is basically derived from the Greek word, that is oikos means a house and logos means a study. Oikos means a house or dwelling place, and or it is also called as an environment. Okay, and the logos means a study, or logi means a study. So collectively it is called as environmental study, or study in house, or study at the dwelling place, in short, right? So therefore, the studies of interrelationships of organism with their physical and biotic environment can be called as a ecology, right? What is the meaning of ecology? What is the definition? The study of interrelationship of organisms, say this shark, okay, study of interrelationship of this shark with its physical and biotic environment, with its aquatic environment, with its other animals, life of other animals, with its prey, or you can say food material, food organism. So this entire relationship is said to be the ecology, right? Now, here I have cited one definition of the ecology, is that the study of life at home with emphasis on kind of relations between organisms and their environment is said to be ecology, right? So number of scientists, they put forth various definitions, okay, of ecology. So if you go in detail with the books, number of definitions of ecology you will come across, right? Now, in 1963, defined ecology as a structure and function of the nature. Okay, what he defined? Epiodom is one of the renowned scientists in ecology, say in environment, right? And he coined this term ecology as a structure and function of the nature, right? Another scientist, that is Ernest Haeckel, in 1866, he said that, or he defined the ecology as a branch of science which deals with the study of relationship between living organism and their environment in immediate vicinity. Okay, so what he said? He said that the study of relationship between living organism and their environment in immediate vicinity. See, I have cited one beautiful example here. This small plant is there, ornamental plant it is. So study of relationship between living organisms, say this plant, and their environment in the immediate vicinity. So its environment is said to be the soil as well as the pot which is holding this plant, right? So studying the relationship of this living organism, that is plant, with the abiotic factor like soil, with the water, with the pot. So this entire picture is nothing but a ecosystem, okay, or ecology. This entire picture is said to be the ecosystem, and studying the behavior of this organism with its biotic and abiotic factor is said to be the ecology. Right? Now, all organisms live in environment. Right? We all live in a particular kind of environment. So, the structure, growth, reproduction, etc. of an organism are controlled by the environmental factors. Right? All the organisms, they live in a particular environment and their structure, growth, reproduction is controlled by environmental factors like soil, temperature, water, nutrients present in the soil. Okay, so along with these factors, the organism themselves interact with each other. Right? So along with the abiotic factors like soil, temperature, water, nutrients, even the living organism, they also interact with one another. So structure and number of organic community of a given area depend upon the environmental and biotic factors which are present in that area. Okay, so structure and number of organic community of a given area is depend on what? The structure of the organic community is depend on the environmental and biotic factors. That again includes abiotic and biotic, means all the living as well as non-living things all together, they are going to comprise the organic community, right? So in the early days, let's go ahead and then continue. In the early days, ecologists used to separate study of ecology into plant ecology and animal ecology. Okay, in initial time period when the ecology was started, studying animal behavior was started. So at that time, the animal ecology was studied separately and the plant ecology was also studied separately. And all together, it is called as a bioecology. Okay, study of a living organism is said to be the bioecology. Study of living organism in their natural habitat, in their in-house condition or in their environment is said to be the bioecology. Okay, now in this bioecology branch in which we study an individual species or its a population in relation to its a biotic, that means a living, and abiotic, that means a non-living environment. Right? Okay. Now, later on, as the studies enhances, science enhances, so this ecology was divided into two main branches, autecology and synecology, rather plant ecology and animal ecology. Okay, this branch is this concept of the animal ecology and plant ecology was not grown ahead. Okay, rather autecology and synecology that comes to existence. Okay, what is the autecology? Let's see. Autecology is the branch of ecology which deals with the study of living organism in relation with its biotic and abiotic environment. It is also known as ecology of individual. Okay. So, a organism, particular living organism, its relation with the biotic and abiotic factor is said to be this autecology. Okay. Now, in this branch, one will study a species of organism or its a population throughout its life, its interaction with the environment and amongst themselves. For example, in a forest, if we study the population of a rat or rat species, its increase in number, food taken by it, its a relation to the plants and other animal living in that locality, its birth rate, death rate, and their interactions within their own population is called autecology. Okay. It's called autecology, means a complete study of a particular individual or a particular species with all aspects. Okay, it's said to be autecology. Then what is a synecology? Synecology is the branch of ecology which deals with the structure, number, development, distribution, and interaction of organic community with the environment as amongst themselves. Okay. Alright, so here what is involved? In the synecology, a single individual is involved. Is it like that? No, a community is involved. Okay, a community is involved. And community means what? Community comprises only a single type of organism. Tell me. No, community comprises of many different types of organism. Many types of organisms are there in a community. Right, let's see in detail about the synecology. So this synecology is a branch of ecology which deals with the structure, number, development, distribution, interaction of organic community of a locality with the environment and amongst themselves as a whole. For the synecology study, ontological knowledge of the individual species is necessary. Okay, the knowledge of individual species is necessary. Thus, ontological studies are necessary to understand the synecology of a given community. If we study the different plants and animals living in a forest and their interrelationship with the environment and amongst themselves, okay, then it is called as a synecology of the forest. Okay, what example we have cited? We have cited an example of the forest and the number of organism living in that forest. Okay, so as in the forest, you can say birds are observed, birds are living in the forest. You can say reptiles are there, rodents are there, then canines are also there, even many other elephants, many other organisms are there. Even grassland ecosystem is also, means grasses, trees, shrubs, right? Birds, all of them are living together. So the different types of plants and animals living in a forest and their interrelationship with environment. Do you believe that a organism living in a particular area has a relationship with its environment? Just what example we have taken? We have taken example of a forest animals. So tell me, these forest animals, they are related or they showing some kind of relation with their environment, that is with the forest? Yes or no? Yes, they show some interaction, some relation with their habitat, that is their environment means a forest, right? This is studied in the synecology. Okay, now let's move ahead and see what are the divisions of ecology. So ecology, as it is, we already said, it is one of the youngest branch of science which has or which involve the study of organism, or you can say the population with its environment. Okay, interrelationship of the population with its environment. So based on the level of organization, kinds of environment, taxonomic position, ecology. Okay, so based on what criteria I said based on the level of organization, kinds of environment, taxonomic position, ecology can be divided into many branches. Okay, so some of the important divisions are here. I have listed habitat ecology, then population ecology, so like that. Let's see what include in the habitat ecology. So this habitat ecology, the first one, very first habitat ecology, study of different habitats of a biosphere. Now what is a biosphere? Biosphere is a life supporting zone. Okay, what is that? It is a life supporting zone which includes both lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere. Okay, so in the habitat ecology, study of different habitats of biosphere is called as a habitat ecology. Say for example, habitat ecology, marine ecosystem, freshwater ecosystem, forest ecosystem, these are said to be the habitat ecology, right? Then the next one is population ecology. Second one, population ecology. So the study of populations of a different species of a ecosystem concerning their birth rate, death rate and different factors affecting their growth in size and number. This is called as a population ecology, study of population of a different species. is said to be the population ecology. Then ecosystem ecology. The third one is ecosystem ecology. Now, it deals with analysis of ecosystem in relation to structure and function, the interrelationship of components of the ecosystem. Okay, so what it means? It means the analysis of an ecosystem in relation to structure and function, and interrelationship of component of the ecosystem. All right, this is included in ecosystem ecology. Now, the fourth one is the conservation ecology. Now, conservation, everybody may know what is a conservation, right? So, on the planet Earth, the different raw materials like coal, water, oil, and minerals, which are required for the welfare of human, but these resources, they are limited, right? They must be properly used. If they are misused in future, or men's life will be in danger if they are misused, right? So to avoid the difficulties for the future generation, we have to plan the utilization of resources properly. In this branch of ecology, we study the proper management methods of natural resources like land, water, forest, sea, oil, minerals, okay, for the benefit of human being. Okay, so this conservation ecology, which tell us to minimize the use of resources, natural resources, so as to benefit the human being, right? Now, the next one is the production ecology. So this branch deals with the gross or net production of a different ecosystem, like freshwater ecosystem, marine water ecosystem, agriculture, horticulture, proper methods of management of these ecosystems, so that maximum production can be achieved by the human being. Okay, so production ecology. So whatever ecosystems are there, like freshwater ecosystem is there, marine water ecosystem, agriculture, horticulture ecosystem, whatever ecosystems are there, the proper method of management of these ecosystem is involved in the production ecosystem, so that maximum products will be achieved by maintaining harmony of the ecosystem is studied in the production ecology. Then radiation ecology. So this branch, in this branch, we study the effects of radiation and radioactive substances on organism and environment. Okay, if this is not properly managed, means what? The radioactive substances and radiations, if not properly managed, the existence of a human race will be in danger. Right, so this is known by everybody that radiation causes a great hazard in our body. It causes kind of a mutation, different kinds of mutation. Because of that, number of generations of a human and other animals becomes or they develop some kind of deformities, genetic problems are there. Even in the area where the radiation are released, or you can say some kind of radioactive elements are there, the land is also become barren, right? So proper management of this radiation and radioactive substances is again very important for betterment of a human life, right? Okay, then paleoecology, it is related with the fossil studies. Okay, so with the help of fossil studies, we can have idea about the nature and structure of the organism living in the ecological past. Say in a particular area, when there was a mining, and meanwhile some kind of fossils they observed, some kind of fossils they found in a specific area. So on the basis of fossils, we can see what was the ecological condition of that area, what kind of animal were living in that area, and what was the situation, what was the environmental conditions at that time. So that can be studied in paleoecology on the basis of fossil studies. In this paleoecology, we study about the different forms living in the different times in the past and the environment prevailing at that time. Okay, so we also study how these life form and environment changed from time to time due to some specific factors. Okay, this knowledge help us as a guide to the future. Okay, this knowledge help us as a guide to future changes which we may try to bring in nature to suit the betterment of human life. Okay, so what was the condition in the past and how the animal they become changed slowly, this knowledge help us to manage with the environment. Okay, to interact with the environment, because the environment is also going to change. Okay, and somehow we are also responsible for this to change, right? So gene ecology, the next one is the gene ecology. Now in the nature, we find that particular species of a genera are having a capacity to survive and other fail to leave, and then they become extinct, right, in the surrounding. Okay, tell me, is it like ki initially when the organisms they form, all of the life forms from that time they still exist today? Is it like that? No, it is not like that. So animals, they get modified, they get become better and better day by day. Some of the organisms, they become extinct. Some of them become tolerate the environment, they become fit for the survival. Now here in this case, the organism which was extinct, okay, during the due course of life, they become extinct. So in their gene pool something was lacking, and the organism which are fit for the survival, okay, they modify themselves according to the environmental conditions. Means something is there inside their genome which allow them to modify, which allow them to adjust with the environment, changing environmental condition, so they become fit for the survival, right? So this is studied in gene ecology. Then the next one is space ecology. Now this space ecology is again one of the most modern and latest branch of ecology, right? So as man is trying to reach other planets which are located far away from Earth, right, for this he has to travel millions of kilometers for the number of days. And in this branch of ecology, the construction and uses of partial or complete regenerating systems in the spaceship and effect of a space travel on the organism are studied. Okay, in the space ecology, how the things are going to change in the space, how the complete regeneration of a particular system is possible in the space, and what is the effect of space traveling on the body of organism or animal, or you can say human, is studied in the space ecology. Okay, now the next branch is the taxonomic ecology. So this taxonomic ecology, it again involved with the study of different taxonomic groups. Okay, now here in this case, different taxonomic groups, say plant, different taxa are there, then animals, even microbial, even vertebrates, number of vertebrates are there. So their taxonomic classification everybody knows, and the study of each taxa with its environment. Okay, say for example, we can take example from the animal, say vertebrates. Okay, vertebrates, how the vertebrates they interact with their environment. Okay, say vertebrates, they are adapted to live in the land, on the, you can say, inside the water, okay, or on the plant bodies. So they interact with their environment indifferently. So that is studied in the taxonomic ecology. And the lastly is the human ecology, where mainly the relationship between the human and his environment is studied. Okay, So we have seen the divisions of ecology. Different divisions are there on the basis of the factor involved and their environment. Okay, so enough for first lecture. Thank you.